let us see the relationship of auditing with other disciplines. In order to complete the auditing process, an auditor should have the following knowledge. That is, he should have the knowledge about accounting, mathematics and statistics, behavioral science, financial management, computer information, law, economics, and all these things. Now let us see in which way it is going to be used. So first one is accounting. So first, in accountancy, how it is used. The major work of the auditor is to evaluate the financial statement, and later he gives the opinion of that statement. In order to give the proper view of the financial statement, he should have the thorough knowledge about accounting concepts and principles. So that is what the major thing is. The auditor should have the knowledge about the financial statement so that he can evaluate it properly. And the next one is mathematics and statistics. Auditor deals with the financial data and the amount that appears in the financial statement. Hence, it requires the knowledge of calculation procedure involved in computing various items. For example, he has to work on with lot of numbers in this. So the auditor should also have a clear-cut view in maths and statistics in order to find the conclusion with the available samples. So you should have the knowledge regarding numbers also, which is related to maths. And the next one is in case of economics. Auditor requires knowledge regarding business and economic environment affecting the client. Thus, economic concepts are required to perform auditing in a meaningful way. So, auditor should also have the knowledge regarding business and economic environment. He should know how a business is working, at the same time in which situation which business should be started. All those economic environment he should be knowing, which will help them to do the auditing in an efficient way. So only then he can do auditing or conduct auditing in an efficient way. And next one is law. Audit of a business concern has to be undertaken with respect to conformity with the law. Thus, an auditor should have sound knowledge of laws affecting their client. So, this auditor should have a sound knowledge about the laws affecting their client, which would be helpful for them to know the real criteria of the situation. If the situation is going to be very hard or the situation is bad, whatever it is, this auditor should know the law points to find the solution for it. So, this law knowledge is also very important. And the next one is computer information system. In recent times, clients maintain their accounts in computer information system. So now everything has come inside computer. So without computer, they cannot do anything. So now in accounting also, computer is playing a very major role. So now accounting data are very easily stored with the help of computer. In order to do it efficiently and quickly, information regarding computer is needed. At least some basic qualities an auditor should have. We cannot tell at least, he should possess a proper quality and knowledge about computer in order to feed the data to the computer and work on it. And the next one is financial management. Auditor, to understand and evaluate the financial statement in a better way, he should have the knowledge of financial techniques. So there are a lot of financial techniques such as ratio preparation, cash flow analysis, fund flow analysis, budgeting, and all these things are some of the financial statement analysis. So they will be analyzing, either they are going to compare the last year with the present year. So like that, comparison and all is needed. So that they use lot of technique use. So the auditor, whoever is going to process the work, he should also have the knowledge about all these techniques. And the next one is behavioral science. Auditor has to deal with many personnel to conduct the audit efficiently. Hence, he should have the tact to get along with the people. So, auditor will not be a permanent person in a business firm. He is a person who will be called in different firms for a particular year in order to complete a particular report. So, this person will be in need to move on with many number of people. So, behavioral science is very important. You should learn about the behavior of a person and its consequence. So, why this person is working like this, why he is reacting like this, all those things he should be knowing. So that it will be easy for him when he moves on with different people having different attitude. So, just now we saw the relationship of auditing with the other behavioral sciences and other disciplines and all we saw. Now let us see who is an auditor. So auditor is a person who checks the accuracy of the books of accounts and expresses his opinion. He's going to express the opinion. He's going to go through the report which is given by the firm. Then he will be giving the opinion regarding it. And the person who is a chartered accountant holding the certificate of practice. So auditor should be a chartered accountant holding the certificate of practice from the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. So enjoys a distinctive professional status in the society because of the specialized functions of auditing. So he is a person who is going to be distinctive from the society in the society because of the status which he got there. And he is going to have a specialized function over there that no one else is going to perform. Only an auditor with a certified proper certificate is given a chance to lead his life very happily. Next, let us see about the functions of an auditor. So what are the functions he performs? He performs examination, books, evidence, full inclusion, properness, verification of assets, statutory compliance, disclosure, truth and fairness, and all these things. These things are related to the working of an auditor. Now let us see how he's going to work. So examination. Auditor should examine the accounting system to ensure about their appropriateness. So you have to check the report and how it is being processed and how it is being prepared. Everything he has to examine. And next is books. Checks the books of account to ensure the arithmetical accuracy. He will check whether the additional work is correct or subtraction work is correct or wherever ratio which has to be divided and given, everything is correct, and all those things he will be checking in the books. And next comes the evidence. The auditor should examine the documentary evidence to support the entries in the books of accounts. He has to check if a particular transaction is being recorded in the book, in the journal entry or ledger. What this auditor has to do is, he has to check the invoice related to the transaction and he has to have a proper evidence on that. And next one is full inclusion. He has to check whether the books have been included while preparing in the financial statement. For example, if you take a particular month, all the transaction taken place in the particular month has to be recorded. So this auditor's major work is to check whether everything is recorded. So people may manipulate it and show, or sometimes they may leave out some of the transaction. So they have to check regarding it. And the next one is properness. Examine whether the information contained in the financial statement is proper and does not contain any fraudulent entry. Any fraudulent entry in the sense, there are some employees who used to take money from the business and they will be showing it with the different transactions over there. So, thirittu kanakku kaattuvaanga, illa yaamaathuvaanga, andha maari varala illama irukkartha, correct ah proper ah irukkaan solittu check pannuvaanga. And the next one is verification of assets and liabilities. He will check how many assets are there and whether the assets are being processed with the proper name and what are the liabilities, when such liabilities are going to be paid, everything he will be checking it out. So check the extension, valuation and disclosure of all assets and liabilities in the financial statement. So the existence of assets and liability will be shown in the financial statement. According to that, you will go to that particular place and you will check whether the assets are valuing or not. And the next one is statutory and compliance. He verifies the compliance of financial statement with the relevant statutory authorities. So after preparing the financial statement, he is going to compare this financial statement with the other statements prepared by the company and he will find out the report out of it. And the next one is disclosures. That is, he will be adding out what are the documents related to this financial statement, what are the invoice to be added, what are the payment bills to be added, everything will be disclosed with it. So he will examine whether the information in the financial statement is disclosed properly as per the accounting principles. So as per the accounting principles, they will check whether everything is being attached to it properly. And the next one is truth and fairness. He will check whether the financial statement represents a true and fair view of loss and of assets and liabilities. So you'll be checking out the true and fair view of the profit and loss account and balance sheet of a business concern. And the next one is which qualities of an auditor. So what are the professional qualities and what are the general qualities you should be having? So first we see about the professional qualities. So you should have the knowledge of accounting principles and concepts. And you should also have the knowledge of principal techniques of auditing. And knowledge of company and mercantile law. Knowledge of cost accountant, knowledge of management accountant, knowledge of mathematics and statistics, knowledge of economics, knowledge of technical details and production process. So these are the things we already saw in the relationship of auditing with other disciplines. The same things they are given as professional qualities. And now let us see what are the general qualities. Tactful and honest. Tactful and honest in the sense, while preparing the report, you should be very honest. Ability to work hard. He has to work very hard in order to give the proper report out of it. So you should find out the reason why such thing is happening. That is what is reasoning. You should be vigilant, cautious and accurate. So vigilant in the sense, he has to be very cautious how this particular work is being done. So how this mistake has happened. Everything, he has to be very cautious and find out the reason for it. Communication skill. So he has to move on with many number of people. So communication skill is very important for him. And next one is impartial. Impartial in the sense, his work, whatever he do, should be properly working out. Impartial irukkakoodadhu partiality paakkaradhu appdi solvaanga yaro. He should not support a particular group of people or particular person in order to safeguard them. So that and all he should not be doing. He should be an impartial person. And next one is ability to trace out the facts and figures. He has to find what are the mistakes there in the invoice and how that mistakes can be found out. And after finding it out, what sort of manipulation work is being done, everything he has to find it out. That particular knowledge is very important for him. And next one is methodical. He will be using different methods to find out the profit and loss from a company's report. So he has to know different methods for it. And ability to maintain secrecy. Until the full report is being given to the company, he should not be telling about the small queries which he is having. He can examine them, but still he is not supposed to tell it out to other people. And next one is well-behaved. He have to behave very properly so that he can work out everything in that form. And next one is courage. He should not be a coward person. He should be a courageous person. Next, he should have a lot of common sense to work in that particular situation. Next, he must be a watchdog but not a blood wound. Watchdog in the sense, when a particular work is being done, he has to be very cautious in it. At the same time, he have to find out the reason why it is happening. And next is, we are going to see about the objectives of auditing. There are two objectives which we are going to see. One is primary objective and the other one is secondary objective. So today we'll see about the primary objective alone. So what are the primary objectives? To examine the accuracy of books of accounts, to express opinion on financial statements. So these are the two primary objectives which they go through. One is they check the accuracy of books, and they will check, after checking everything, they are going to express what report has to be given to the firm.